Foxhill, the top in the corner. Off the championship as well, having another rider in the reckoning as well. Alvin Austin third, Dylan Walsh in fourth. Len McCormick still in fifth place. Martin Barr, Liam Knight, Tom Grimshaw, Mike Gray, and Matt Burrow running up the top 10. Bob Yates goes through. Up to 7th place now. Number 4, Roglic, 2:22, Charlie Powell, and Ashton Dickinson. They both quit and go back. Ashton Dickinson moving into 9th position. Just ahead of Tom Grimshaw, who's up to 10th. And the number 9 at Rose Hall, the team Reeves, moving it into 12th position. Come down into the valley for the first time. Rizzi takes lead. It's Mike Carter down the inside, retaking the lead. They are side by side, almost like a rhythm race along the first side. Mike Carter gets you back into the lead. ATM is third. That's the pilot to Colin Scott. Bernie Alhart coming back there. The 712 of Josh Peters. Lost third place. Tom Burton fourth. Cullen drops to fifth position. Good clean start. Everyone seems to have got through the first few corners okay. And Ike Carter then grabbing the lead once again. He got the hole shot past the Honda Revenge turn to hole shot point first. Coming away slightly from Rizzi. The top two starting to break away already from the rest of the field as they make their way round the back of the circuit, disappearing out of view for just a few moments. And they wind their way around the very back of the Foxhill circuit, coming back towards us for the first time. And it is still the Yamaha of Ike Carter, who leaps down the hill via some downhill section into the bowl before Heartbreak Hill. And Carter leads. Rizzi still in second, and 7-1-2 of Josh Peters trying to tag on those two lead riders. Tom Murphy in there as well. Cullen Scott, KTM in sixth. Could be Aaron Padstone possibly. We'll confirm that when they come back towards us. But Ike Carter making his way back towards MSR, red line Yamaha. Rizzi trying the inside line, but not close enough to go for that. Peters third.
Strong. Welcome back. times. It's an exciting lap for the MX2.
Racing at the front.
party, and this time Josh Gilbert has made the move stick, and now Albin Ostrom is starting to take under pressure. Fended off his teammate. And of course, that's the second and third place are teammates. So, Lee Hansen, number 13, 20th place, a bit further down the track. Heading now towards the closing stages of this 25 minute plus 2 lap moto. And still, Josh Gilbert leads the way. Gilbert still from Walsh.
On the blue line there, we're getting close.
Closing up on the rival, so look out for Josh Peters, number 712 on the Gabriel Insulation Services Yamaha, as he goes up the Foxhill Valleys round the back of the circuit for another lap. Still being closed on by the number 150, Aaron Padstone, Renron, Kestrel, KTM. Very fast paced race leader, John Lee, back to the race 217.817. Fast best lap Now here we go, John Whizzy with one lap to go. Drive the inside of Mike Carter. Carter notices then, immediately switches their way through there. Shiaru Honda as well, he's been lapped all the time. Finished right now, Mike Carter leads from John Whizzy. Still about two more corners to go. It's going to be close here. Rizzi has a look down the inside, but he can't make the move. And it looks like Ike Carter's going to take the win. Checker flag goes out, and Ike Carter is your race winner. Joel Rizzi just behind. Back to podium area, just next to the train stall at the top of the valley here. Of course, our trade stands, our series sponsors, Protein up there as well, along with the bar and the refreshments providers. That will all take place at the end of the day. Provisional results of MXY2.
Yeah. Simpson. Elliot Manton continuing to close them on Tommy Searle for second. The back of the third page here, he's holding on to that sixth position.
Position going up the Foxhill, the first of those two climbs the first time, and Adam trying the outside of Lewis
to win. He's got things under control. He comes up here in second. Tommy Searle charging in the final lap, trying to keep the pressure on Elliot Banks down to second place. Over the back, Pocock still in fourth. Harry Field is still charging as leaders make their way towards the finish line. And concern the checkered flag being waved. Accelerates with a wheelie as he goes over the line. He keeps the title race alive going into the final round. Ed Mandrake next month. Second position will be Elliot Banks charging over the line. Tommy Searle in third.